Is Devin here?
That'll be.
Oh, that'd be great. Yes, please.
All right.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
So my name is Devin Cardenas, and I'm with the North Bay Organizing Project. We come to the issue of rent stabilization and just cause eviction policies really from the point of view that in moments of crisis, which I think we're all in agreement, I think I've heard that verbalized several times, that local government actually has a role in protecting the most vulnerable, working people, middle-class people. So rent stabilization, just cause eviction policies are actually a means by which we can have a greater role in democratizing the process of how we go about this issue. I wanted to just briefly refer to a few things because I've spoken with some individually about what rent control is, because I think there's also a little bit of confusion. So I'm going to read off a few things. Rent control will not affect properties issued a certificate of occupancy before 95. It will not affect single home, family homes, and condominiums. And rent control must allow landlords a fair rate of return. Property owners may amortize the cost of capital improvement. So I just want to put that out there just so we're all clear around what rent control is, who it will affect. I actually think it's not enough. It's the smallest thing the city can actually do. It's the most simple thing that we can actually do to protect renters and make sure that this does not become a playground for the wealthiest amongst us. I do also want to refer, I'm familiar with the name David Silver because of the Hohen and Yalupa residents that we all know from the beginning of the year, so I have a face to the name now, that's very nice. But I just wanted to put that out that we'd also really like to make sure that a moratorium, a rent moratorium, conversation happens before this broader conversation. There's no timeline for this broader conversation. We all agree it's very important that it happens, but in the meantime, what can we do to stop the bleeding and the people that are getting squeezed? So,
thanks, Dan.
Thank you. An inclusive process is going to take. And if we could have a quick, thoughtful, and inclusive process, I would not be moving this forward. But if it's going to take a long time for us to have a conversation, and then once we implement housing actions, do we really think that we're going to change our permitting streamlining process and have housing tomorrow? Or do we think it's going to take another 5 years for those homes to be constructed or longer, depending upon the methods that we're using, depending on the economy, depending on many things? How long will our thoughtful and inclusive process take? And what will happen to the people who are renting while we wait? I want to protect people who are working here now while we take our time, while we have an inclusive process. I had a phone call today telling me that if our workforce can't afford to live here, they should move away. I don't believe for a minute that most people here feel that way. I believe most of us value our workforce here in Santa Rosa. I believe most of the people in this room value those folks. I don't believe telling them to move to Lake County or somewhere else is a solution. And I am calling for a temporary, for us to move forward, a temporary moratorium on rent increases while we take the time to work this out. And that's my motion.
And he's 88. And I think that even though he wouldn't do this probably because he's such a sweet old guy, but if I was a little less sweet and I was concerned about a rent moratorium going into place and I was only charging what he's charging, I think I might consider a rent increase. And so what this is doing, I think, is could actually have an unfortunate reaction, which is people get out of fear of the rent moratorium, all of a sudden, tomorrow, it's the first of the month, and those 30-day notices go out, and they have their rent increase for whatever is allowable by law. So that's the fear, that's the concern. I think that in some ways we are creating a problem as opposed to solving one. So that's my concern, and that's why I will not be supporting this, putting this on the agenda.
I am trying to hit the pause button on rent increases so that we can have a thoughtful and considered conversation. I want to protect our renters while we have a conversation. I did try to bring it forward as an urgency item so that we didn't have the unintended consequences of rent increases while we had the conversation, and I was unable to obtain the supermajority for that, so we are going through the slower process. But if we don't go through this process, we are currently experiencing sharp increases in rent. We were experiencing it before we talked about rent control or rent increases. This is a consequence of the behavior of some to sharply increase rents. And it's a consequence of a condition where we have a 1.5% vacancy rate. And we have a big, long-term problem to solve. A problem that is probably not going to be solved over 5 years. And a temporary moratorium, while we get a handle on it, a temporary pause so that people can take a breath and stay employed and working and living in the same community is what I'm trying to do. So I hope that that we can move forward with this. I appreciate that it is very important for us to handle our homeless and housing aspects, but I think that this is a step to prevent homelessness as we move forward.